Hello everyone, welcome back, I'm Lincoln, and today we're going to jump into Nomad Sculpt. And if you clicked on the thumbnail, you already know most of the story. We have some amazing objects and figures we can bring into Nomad Sculpt now. So let's jump in. What we'll do is we'll go in here, and this is the scene that I had on the thumbnail. And you can see they're not perfect in the back, but that's not a big deal. The main thing is that you can add all these in. So let's turn all these off. And now you would think that this would be in the add section right here, and it's not. It is, these are all still just the primitives, repeaters. There is something new in the repeaters I want to show you, but for now, we're going to add some scenes, things into these scenes. And you go into the file folder at the top and hit this new button up here, preset. And you'll see here that we have a ton of things. Now, the first two, the array and the tube, that is just a demo, like it's labeled there. It kind of shows you what you can do by doing these random repeaters I'll show you in a minute. But you've got two different hands, realistic and stylized. You've got all these different heads, primitive, planar, generic, sculpting, animation, anyway. And then jaws, you got realistic and stylized. And then posable female, posable male, those are the ones that I used on the thumbnail. And then down here, you have the skulls, the realistic one I used. And then I used, well, let's see, I used the realistic male and the stylized female. And then down here, you have the solo, and they're just one piece. So if we go up here, let's just grab any one of these. We'll grab the stylized male and bring it in. So you tap on it once, tap on it a second time, and add to scene. And yes. And there you go. Now, if you look in the here, you can see that we have the hierarchy. And the cool thing about this is that it is already all done for you. So if we grab the shoulder that everything moves, grab the forearm, only the forearm and hand moves. And it's all built on the hierarchy. So if you grab the pelvis, everything goes with it. Grab the leg, you can come up, bring this down, and you can even do the toes. If you want to move the toes around, you can do everything. So it's already been set up for you, which is cool. So we're going to bring this all the way back to the beginning. And so that's something that's really awesome. And then if you look here at the head, the eyes, you actually have separate eyelids even. So you can move the eyelids down, bring this up, close the eyes. You can turn the eyes. So pretty cool. It's really nice that it's all been put together for you. The bridge of the nose is even different. So this part is separate from this part of the nose. So there's been a lot of work they put a lot of work into this to put it together. The only thing they didn't do, and you could add if you wanted to, were the rest of the joints for the toes and for the fingers. But for the most part, it's going to get you 99% of the way as far as easy posability and ease of use. So let's look at some of the other things we have here. Now you notice up at the top left that, or on yours might be top right, but you have this new beaker on here. So if you click on this, it's called operation. So it's pretty interesting. There's a lot of things in here that you can use, and it's cool because it's after the fact. If you paint this, so we're gonna paint this real quick, and I'll paint it, let's paint it this crazy orange. This one. And apparently I've changed the colors. So we'll do a crazy green, doesn't matter. Okay, so later on down the line, I decide I don't like this color. I've already painted it, and I want to do something different. So go up here again and click on, so you've got different sections. So you got the smoothing section, I'll show you here in just a few. You got all the colors, and then down at the bottom, you got the colors again for blur. So this one at the bottom, you would think that would be what you want to do, but there's nothing to blur because you only have one color. If you had several multiple colors on here, you can get really nice blur effects with this. It's really cool. But for this, we go into this middle section right here and tap on hue. Now this one's on opacity, so you can see what that does. It doesn't really matter which one you use. It's going to change it all the same because this one says opacity. So come over to color instead. And now you've got all the different things you can do. You can change. You can change all the hues, change the contrast, change the saturation, change the exposure. So it's kind of cool. You can really dial in a color on something if you want with this. Same thing if you want to change the roughness. You can make it softer or harder as far as that goes. Now the metalness, usually that's with hue, it seems like down here. Opacity, which you already saw, you can do a mask the same way. Now this is pretty cool because you can soften the mask if you want, which is pretty cool. It's a little bit easier to do because it does it over the whole thing instead of having to tap on the object to get on the actual mask to get it to soften for you. A little more controlled with a slider. It's pretty nice. So let's do another color on here real quick. So I'll grab the paint tool, which I should just move up here because I might use it more than once. So I'll go up here, paint, and I'll just pick a color. What green is fine. So we'll paint this crazy green on here. Okay, so here's where that would work as far as the color. You can blur this together and they'll kind of blur into each other. So you can do some really nice fades and it's all by slider control. So it's really easy to control. So pretty cool anyway. All right, so the other thing up here, you can also smooth. Now, since this is a pretty rough polygon, if we smooth this right now, it's just gonna shrink it up really heavily. So instead, we'll come up here, let's go to voxel, and we'll bring the resolution up a bit and remesh it. Now you can see they've got a much better wire. Now, the cool thing about this, instead of always we're trying to use a smooth brush and go all the way around and get everything smooth, we use the slider and it does it the whole head at the same time. And it's kind of crazy. If you guys have done any 3D printing, it kind of does the same effect where you'll see in the top of the nose and the bottom of the nose. And then over here on the side of the head, sometimes it gets the circles on there, which is kind of crazy, but it's an easy thing to finish up. Just a touch bit of smoothing here and there, instead of trying to smooth the entire thing and having an issue with something. So pretty cool. All right. The other thing I want to show you, and this is kind of makes a difference, kind of doesn't. So we'll go into face group real quick, go up to patch, add a patch, and I need to paint instead of relax. So we got this going right here, and we'll change the size a little bit because that's kind of big, so it can be kind of rough. Okay, now let's go here. We can just slide down to relax on the beaker, on the operation, and you'll see what happens is this thing does glitch a little bit now with this. So you can see here that it's really relaxing all those out. You can take it back and you can see that the edges of your face group have really relaxed. You can do the same thing with the relax button over here, but you have to go all the way around, where instead you can just smooth the entire thing at one time. So pretty interesting. All right, so I think that's about it on here. You can also inflate. You can inflate the entire thing. So you want to make the biceps a little bit bigger. Now I'm going to do a trick because I have my keyboard on. I can hit shift and tap this other one and get them both. You could go up in the menu and do the same thing. And we can inflate both at the same time. So it's pretty cool. It's really nice because you can kind of bulk this character out. And then if you wanted to give them big forearms, smaller wrists, so make them all Popeye-ish, you could easily mask and smooth that mask out using all these techniques. All right, so I think we're done in there. Let's go over to the repeaters. So this is super cool. So we're gonna go in here and I'm gonna select this and unselect it. And then we'll just pick the head and add it doesn't matter which one of these use really, but I'm going to use a curve. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Need to add, let's see, first, let's unselect everything, then add a sphere. And let's find it. Where is it? Shrink this down. And the cool thing with this, it doesn't really matter how much you shrink it down, because you'll be able to randomize this as much as you want. So come in here and add a repeater to it. So I just add a curve. And you'll see down here in the right-hand corner, all the way to the right, where it says randomize. So first, we're going to give this a few. And go to the line. Stretch it out. And let's kind of make it kind of a funky shape. And then we're going to close the loop. So I'll hit close. Now the cool thing is we can add a few more of this, a few more to this. And we're going to go and tap the randomize. And you'll see on this menu, if we keep this up here, moving over a little. And you can change the translation so it starts moving them off the line that they have. You can rotation, which won't make any difference because they're spheres, obviously. They're not going to turn around like a cube or another shape. Then you can change, randomize the scale, change the translation some more. And suddenly you can have a lot of stuff going on really quick. And you still have all the control of the actual line itself. And if you want to say, make all the radiuses different, you can still change the randomness by just changing a few of these here and there. So super cool. You can do some really super cool effects with this really quick. So let's just click on the sphere so you can kind of get the line out of the way. So pretty cool. You can do that, because that opens up so many possibilities for so many different things. You can do the same thing with array. You can do the same thing with all of the other repeaters. I think even mirror. Yeah, mirror has it too. It's the only one I didn't check earlier. So super cool with this. All right. I hope you found something useful in this video. There's a lot of new things in this version of Nomad in 2.1. So have fun sculpting with all this and just explore all those options and just kind of think about what you want to do. Oh, there is one other thing I want to show you in the operations menu. So if you come to the operations, the one thing that will happen if you paint something a color, now if we come into operations and you change the color by changing the hue, change the color, you're going to notice something. If you go into the paint menu, it hasn't changed. So if you need to match this color or change it or match it to something else, it's going to be as simple as grabbing the eyedropper, clicking on this, and now you have the color of however you change it in your post-painting, basically. All right, I hope you guys found something useful in this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.